大家好，欢迎来我们的媒体见面会。Hello everyone and welcome. Welcome esteemed press and media to the press conference for Lost in the Pacific, being directed by Vincent Zhou. We have everyone here. Please sit down if you can. We're going to start off by announcing everybody that's part of this team and part of this Hollywood blockbuster that we're creating here. We're going to start off with the director, Vincent Zhou. This is my co-host, Melanie.
Nice to meet you guys. Please have your seat and grab your drink with you. And we're going to introduce the Ballet Film on Launch, the press conference, and welcome everyone. Thank you.
Next, we're going to bring on Craig Borden, Hollywood Assistant Director.
Okay, let's welcome our Director of Visual Effect, Bruce Jones.
And next, we'll be bringing our talent. Oh, do we have here Scott Winnig? There was Scott Winnig. Well, welcome, Scott Winnig.
So let's welcome our most exciting character, Braden Roth, our Superman. Please come up.
I think he's gonna fly in. So. And last but not least, we want to welcome the most famous young actress in Asia at this moment, Zhang Yuqi. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we want to welcome this film, Lost in the Pacific, being directed by Vincent Zhou. This film is got all the elements of a Hollywood blockbuster: action, complicated characters, intense drama, all in one film, and those elements is what it takes to make a successful Hollywood film. But this is a first of its kind. It's not only a Hollywood blockbuster, but it's also a Chinese Hollywood co-production being filmed starting March. And Vincent, he may look young, but he's got what it takes, and he's done it before, and we're very, very proud of him to make this film and to create this action on, you know, with planes and, you know, the extreme effects. So really, this is a special time, and you should be very lucky to be here in this room at this moment before the production. Do you want to say in Chinese, or?
OK， 女士们、先生们，欢迎来到我们现场，参加我们正发太平洋美国媒体见面会的现场。我是主持人 Melanie，and this is my 这是我的合作主持人 Carrie。好莱坞的冒险剧作通常都会有很复杂的故事剧情，同时也融集了很多特别高端的特效，还有奇奇怪怪的人物在里面。这些关键元素足以让我们的生产元素飙升，所以让我们很期待这部电影。在这个好莱坞一线制作团队倾力打造的冒险电影同时，我们融集了亚洲、中国的卡斯阵容。这些极具冲击力的阵容和特效，让在这部电影在拍之前已经云集了很多多方的瞩目。所以在我们让我们在现场一起见证这一个激动时刻的到来。首先我再给大家介绍一下我们的主创，用中文。首先我们的导演周文武贝，然后是我们的特效导演Bruce Jones， please stand up。OK， 我们的第一导演Craig Borden， and 我们的超人先生 Braden， 还有 还有我们的最美的东方面孔玉琪小姐，还有 Scott 先生，欢迎你们到来。
我还补充一句，还有我们的摄影指导 Scott 魏，
欢迎大家。
We would like to, before going into have everyone speak, we would like to, she just introduced everybody to what they do. Scott Winnig is the DP, he's the director of photography for the film. And we didn't announce that earlier. But we'd like to, before getting started, talk about the film a little bit. This film, there hasn't been a film like this in a long time. I mean, you know, in Hollywood's history, there are famous films on ships and on planes, but nothing as famous as Titanic. Titanic is a film that, you know, it touched people's hearts. It had action elements. It had a storyline. It had history, and this film has the intention of being another Titanic, in the sense that it will touch people's hearts and also will get the thrill of your heart at the same time. The story has been recently a very hot topic. A lot of people, it's been a lot of press about it. There's been a lot of buzz about it. It was at Berlin Film Festival, and it pre-sold to a lot of countries. So this film has already been moving very fast in the public's eye, but we want to find out more about why it's the way it is. Why has this been such a popular film, and why is this there's so much buzz about it? So we want to ask the filmmakers and the talent themselves. So, yeah.
Okay, I'm going to translate in Chinese. 所以在这部电影开拍之前，全世界比较有名的海洋的比较激情的电影就只有泰坦尼克号了。所以我们在就是一直到把这部电影拍到那样的程度，经历了这一场奢华的奇幻冒险，所有的这些演员，都经历了一场就是惊心动魄的瞬间。所以这部电影在刚刚结束的柏林电影节上已经获得了很多的关注。在这个全球知名的电影发行公司 ArcLight 负责预售这部电影，在柏林亮相，在还没有拍拍之前就已经获得了很多媒体的青睐。他们的海报还有剧情构思已经是非常的就是影响壮大，所以我不禁在想到底这个蒸发太平洋有什么的魅力可以引起如此的关注。现在我们主创在现场，所以我们就要问一些问题，关于他们在其中的角色以及这个故事的剧情到底是怎么样的，我们很期待。
I'd also like to add, I was listening to what you were saying, and to mention that ArcLight, this very, very respected sales and production company, has pre-sold the film at Berlin. Well, going to our cast and crew, we're gonna start with Craig. Craig is a Hollywood AD, if those who don't know, an assistant director, and he's done films such as Taken and Frozen, some really high voltage films he's worked on. So want to ask you, Craig, you know, having done these kind of, thank you, Brandon. I was gonna do this. Having done these kind of very intense action films and working on this script, what differences do you see from this and the other action and thrillers that you've worked on?
I think it's very similar. It's the same type of action that I'm used to with choreographed fighting and some gunfire, and you know, it's a high intensity, fast moving film, which is a lot of what I've done in my career.
It's very similar.
Very similar.
Tashuo.
所以他说这部电影和其他以前他制作的电影基本上都差不多，然后至于说那个动作方面基本上是一样的那种套路，但是他觉得在这个电影里头还是得到一些新鲜的感受。
I would also like to ask you, Craig, what are differences that you're experiencing working with a Chinese director? Have you had to learn Chinese for this? Is the film going to be in Chinese? I mean, how are you going to be able to run the set, you know, doing a Chinese American co-production?
Well, everybody that I've met so far that I've had to talk to speaks English very, very well, which has made it a lot easier. I hear that I will have an interpreter over there.
I'm working on my English.
That's good. That way we can talk while we're at work, maybe. Where was I?
Sorry.
That's okay. My train of thought's not covered at best. That was probably not a good thing. It's the only real difference right now is that we just have people in different countries, whether there's some people in America, some people working in Malaysia, some people working in China right now, and just having to communicate back and forth all on the different time zones and stuff, and everybody in different part of the country. That's been a little more challenging than usually, like here we have everybody in the same room, but with this type of production, we're not able to because it is a co-production, you know, with different countries shooting in a third country.
所以我的主持人问的问题是在参加这部电影的时候最大挑战是什么，是说他要先学中文吗？然后Craig回答的是，就是他觉得最大感激就是在现场基本大家都很会说英文，所以就不用再学中文了。然后他觉得这部电影最大的挑战是整个电影是全世界的一个制作，所以大家要跨越不同的时间和地域来沟通来演绎，同时在马来西亚这些拍的剧组的人们在那边，还有一些在中国，还有一些人在美国这边，所以这个构成了一个很大的一个挑战对于他来说。但是我相信 I believe it's a good experience that you cross different culture and time zone and
I think it makes it very interesting. I love that it's so multicultural, and that I am going to Asia to film this, and I think when you have influences from a lot of different people from different cultures, it's very impressive, and a really special thing can come out of it. And I'm really looking forward to the collaboration with working with everybody up here and everybody on the production.
他觉得很激动、很难忘的地方就是，大家都是在拥有不同的文化，然后他们在被不同的文化之间彼此影响。他觉得这个是一个很有意思的事情，但是他还没有在拍，所以他是很期待这个化学反应的。
I would like to also ask Craig to please talk about your experience so far working with the director, can you share anything about any of the action sequences or anything that, you know, is there any kind of secrets that you could leak?
I don't leak secrets, and I don't name names. I think Vincent has a very, very certain image in his mind of what, visually, of what he wants to do, which I think is very impressive. And it's such a pleasure working with a director when they know exactly what they want and what they see and how they see the film in the end and with what they're trying to accomplish. And that's been one of the things working with Vincent, that he sees what it is, past of just the pages that we're looking at, the whole vision behind it.
所以我主持人问的问题是，他可不可以透露一些动作的秘密在这个电影里面？然后Craig 说他不能透露任何的，但是他觉得很高兴，就是跟 Vincent 导演合作，因为这个导演他确实知道他到底想要什么，到底什么样的动作，什么样的剧情和那个故事版，他都知道他自己想要什么，所以这样子对于 Craig 来说是很好沟通的，所以他觉得这样子的工作是很有意思、很轻松、很开心的。
One last question for Craig: Is there anything you'd like to share about the film that you know you want the public to know?
It's going to be awesome.
最后一个问题是你有没有什么更多的想说这个电影？他说一定会。
Okay, thank you so much, Craig. Thank you.
My pleasure.
Now we would like to talk to, the director, Vincent Zhou. Actually, I can speak to you in English. I just found out Vincent speaks English really well. 但是你要融中文还是?
Both.
Okay. Very good. I I can tell a lot of people are excited about this film, and there's a lot of media buzz about this film. But can you tell us more about this film and what really inspired you to create this? Because making a film is not easy, and it takes a lot of time and effort. What is it that inspired you? What is it that you really need to make it? Do you need a translation?
所以问主持人很想知道到底就是什么激起他的兴趣来做这样一部动作电影。
I think the most inspiration for me on this film is the Chinese market. I think everybody knows the Chinese market is booming, and it will rise up, maybe go even beyond American market in 5 years. But so far, we don't have all kinds of genre movie in China, yeah, especially for the Chinese movie. We have lots of comedy, romance, historical story, but we don't have that kind of sci-fi, disaster, adventure movie. So as a Chinese new generation of director and writer, I would like to make one just for, you know, the Chinese audience, and also for other, you know, audience worldwide, if they, you know, they are crazy about this kind of sci-fi adventure movie. So I write a story, and then I have some, you know, support with my investors. Then we just start. I'm a quick, you know, quick decision maker. So I always, you know, take actions. Yeah, once I have an idea.
所以温森导演说，激起他来做这样一部电影的缘由是他觉得中国市场是一个很大的激动点，同时呢，就是中国一直都有很多的喜剧还有浪漫电影，但是一直都没有这样一部 sci-fi 的，就是科幻的，同时又有灾难这种像2012这样的片子。于是他说他自己是一个就是想到就做到那种人，他想到了，所以他就写了这个剧本，所以他写出来了之后，他就找到了他的投资方啊，谈了这样的电影，现在他就坐在这里，然后来要给大家看这个电影，所以年底就要出来了，所以我们很激动。
One more reason is I love to have chemistry with my crews, just like Craig.
他说他真喜欢这个科学，是吧？就是那个，可以说科学还是，the chemistry 的。
另一个原因是他希望，就是他觉得跟这个 crew 跟这个阵容合作是很有那种化学反应的，尤其是跟 Craig， 尤其是跟 Craig 是我们的动作导演，他觉得这样的合作是很有激情的。
Cool, very cool. I must say the confidence and the, you know, comes right out in your words, and it's really inspiring to all of us. I have another question. Actually, before I get into that, I'm really curious for this story in this film, or just in films in general, what are films that inspire you, and what inspires you as a filmmaker?
As a filmmaker, I think the most important thing is to realize a dream. You know, in my mind, actually, I always take a movie industry not only as a storyteller, yeah, but also a dream realizer. Because I think for the Chinese audience and American audience as well, to realize a dream in such 120 minutes in a theater and throw out all the, you know, troubles they are facing with in the daily life, that's very important for us. Yes, I feel very confident, and I feel very honored to deliver that kind of experience to each audience.
I have a question.
What is the question?
The question is what inspired
you? 相同的问题就是到底什么是就是生活中的原因刺激他做这个电影的，然后温森导演说他是一个就是喜欢把梦圆成电影的人，然后他觉得这个梦圆成电影不是光是讲故事，应该是把自己生活中的一些想法和感觉把它真正变成电影故事片里的东西，所以这个是刺激他很想做这样电影的一个原因。
So this this is a true Hollywood and Chinese co-production in every element that we've learned about. How did you make this happen?
I've been trying to make this kind of co-production from my first movie. My first movie is an object movie. It's a thriller. We shoot in Thailand. And except me, all of the main crew are international filmmakers. But this time, we got much more budget. So I'm able to have a Hollywood standard main crew team, just like, yeah, we're all sitting here, except Ian Bailey. He's our production designer. He's working in Malaysia. And I think I would like to call it a new experiment for the Chinese film industry. Because, you know, for the Chinese film industry, we only have five years history for the commercial movie. Before that, we don't have real commercial film market. So it's very short history. So we are lack of every position of the crews. So why not we have a collaboration with American filmmakers? Since, yeah, you know, I born in Shanghai, since, you know, so many Western people living in Shanghai. So we all work together in the other industries. Why not we can make a, you know, international film, yes, with, you know, the top level of the Hollywood filmmakers. So then I go to Hollywood, then I try to, you know, find a recruit my main crews, then also casting internationally. So finally, we have everybody sitting here.
所以主持人问题是究竟是什么最后促使这部电影这个国际合作的电影最后成功走上现在这个舞台然后 Vincent 导演回答的是他其实一直都有这样一个动机和梦想是想做这个国际电影的在他第一部就是小电影的时候他是在泰国拍的他在泰国拍的时候呢所有的阵容的所有的人全部是国际的阵容没有一个是来自中国的除了他以外所以 从那个之后，他现在找到了更多的这个投资，所以他觉得为什么我们不能做一个好莱坞，就是这个等级的电影。所以他现在到了这个等级之后，他就开始在全世界搜索他想要的这个阵容和演员。所以他现在走到这步，他说他是在上海出生长大的，他觉得在那个世界里面有很多 外国的国际的友人，然后他在受那些文化的影响。他以前都是很多人都是在为这个国际的友人工作。他现在觉得应该把这个能量给他吸纳回来，然后做中国人自己的电影。然后中国人的商业电影就只有5年的历史，所以他觉得这个时间太短了。他希望就是自此之后开始做更多的我们中国的商业电影。
Thank you so much for your great response. I have so many questions, but it would take up like 8 hours. But based on this experience that you've already put through, you know, making this film and also your prior film, and seeing the two markets, China and US, the most powerful film markets in the world, what do you find to be the differences currently between US and China?
I think the difference from the American audience and Chinese audience is very obvious. You know, the Chinese audience, yeah, say they're crazy about, you know, big budget movies such as visual effect movie, Marvel movie. So that's why we are making Lost in the Pacific, yeah, which, you know, deliver a lot of sense of the imagination, a whole new world, yeah, many big visual effect scenes. The Chinese audience, they love it, and also, yeah, they love comedy and romance, but extremely they love this kind of visual effect movie. But I think in the American market, you know, since they already have lots of these kind of movies, so they're not, you know, just that open for this kind of movie. The story should be very, very good, and, you know, but in China, I think we are still on the first stage. So that's why we like to make Lost in the Pacific, because yeah, it's more easier for us to success.
主持人问的问题是，中国的这个观众市场和美国观众市场的区别到底是什么？Vincent导演说，这个区别很明显，就是中国的观众是很喜欢看这种好莱坞式的商业的大片，尤其是这种带着这种科幻的还有特效的这种东西。至于美国市场的话，已经有很多这样子类似的片子，比如像《超越归来》这样子的片子。所以，如果你的故事不是就是百分百好的话，估计是很有难度的。所以他说，现在在中国市场里面，这个科幻电影才是初级的这个等级。所以只要你就是做出足够的努力的话，这样的科幻电影的话，一定会是有很好的市场和大家的关注度的。所以他觉得这个是中国和美国的市场的区别。
I have a small question based on your answer. What do you feel the response would be to this film in the U.S., to the U.S. market?
Actually, I would like to leave this question to Brandon.
Okay. All right, well, we'll get to that.
Since he's a local, yeah.
Oh, okay. Actually, that was my next question was, you know, you're a good-looking guy, but you've got the most handsome guy in Los Angeles County right next to you and the most beautiful woman right next to you. How did you find these beautiful specimens of actors?
The beautiful woman just sit beside me and the handsome guy just sit beside on my right hand. They're already in my mind. Yeah, even before I start writing. Yeah, that's true. Yeah, actually, Yuqi's agent is just sitting there. Yeah, she can, you know, prove that. At the very beginning, yeah, I told her I want Yuqi to play Ruoxin, the captain, the hero in my movie. And also, Brandon, yeah, as a Superman, he's the perfect, you know, candidate for us to make him a Chinese American hero in Lost in the Pacific. So because he's just there. He's hero already. Yeah. Once we saw him, almost all the Chinese people, all the Chinese audience, they would regard him as a hero.
我的主持人首先问的第一个问题是，他问一下导演到底说最后美国市场对于这部电影的反应是会怎样的？然后温森导演回答是这个问题应该问我的超人先生。然后超人先生觉得很害羞，所以我的主持人又问了另外一个问题是，他是怎么找到了这两个这么漂亮的主演的。然后Vincent 导演说，他最开始在写这部剧的时候，他就已经这两个人已经在他的剧里面了，他就是照这两个人写出了这个剧本。然后所以他说，你可以问雨琦的这个经纪公司，说是不是他在写这个片子的时候就已经征询过他们的意见，然后是他是想要用雨琦当这个主演的。然后看来是这样子。然后当然说超人先生就是没有什么可说的，肯定是这个中美超人的这个最佳人选。所以他当时在写这个片子的时候已经中意到这两个人了，所以现在是梦想成现实。
It's really, really cool. Wow. 就是缘分。Really. When you set your mind to do something, you know, and it's there, it comes true. That's really beautiful. So now that you talked about Brandon so much, we're going to have to get some words from Brandon. But in Chinese, of course. 我跟你讲，问你，你，这是你第一部电影在中国还是 ？No, is this your first Chinese film, or have you already like? Because you have tons of fans over there, I know, because I've seen them in.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
Hello to all of them. No, this is my first Chinese film.
我的主持人问，这是你第一部中国电影吗？但是你已经有很多的影迷在中国了。然后关键先生回答的是，是的，是我第一部中国电影。
I don't think we need to list your film credits, but I'm going to have to say, just for the people that have been, you know, frozen in time for the past, you know, 10 years, Superman Returns, the one where the great one with Michael Cera,
Scott Pilgrim
versus the world. I mean, that was fun. That was a great
character.
Thank you. This is your first Chinese film. Have you heard about working with it is an international crew, but do you have any kind of expectation about filming in China, or I mean filming in Malaysia, but with a, on a Chinese film?
Well, I have great expectations now, having met and having had a chance to really sit down and talk with Vincent and the rest of our the crew as the early stages of meeting everyone. I'm looking forward to you know, the great potential that we have to make you know, a really cool co-production, U.S. Chinese co-production of a you know, what could be a big time, you know, Hollywood like movie. I mean, that's certainly the intention.
超人先生的这个电影记录我们就不用再说了，他已经演过很多电影，然后就说他对于这个电影的期待到底是怎么样的，因为是国际的合作。然后他说他之前还不太知道，但今天他见到所有的这个阵容和演员，他觉得这还是一个初级的舞台，他们还没有交流太多，但他已经很期待了，他觉得有很多潜在的这个化学反应会存在于所有的这个演员和阵容之间，他觉得这个会是一个 很有激情的作品，他很开心能在这里作为这个主演。
Sounds better when she says it.
Speaking of expectations, I need to go here because we have the press, and Chinese press especially, they love it. You have, seriously, in Asia, the most beautiful actress you're working with. I mean, seriously, she's like, for the young generation, she's known as the most beautiful actress in Asia.
Oh, I can see why.
Jiang Yuqi, really. I saw her picture on Google, I'm like, so beautiful. No, there was clothes on. Do you have any expectations of working with her? Have you gotten to know her at all? Have you guys gotten to work at all together?
We just met an hour ago, and we're talking about California and how great it is in California. But, you know, we're certainly excited to, excuse me, I'm excited to you know, get to work, and, you know, it won't be hard to have her, you know, be the leading lady, as she's, you know, very talented and easy on the eyes, as they would say.
就是你对于这个跟这么漂亮的最漂亮的新的亚洲演员姑娘合作到底会有怎么样的期待，然后Brandon先生回答是他其实也才刚见到雨琦美女，然后他也才跟他见到一个小时，他们聊了聊加利福尼亚是怎么样子，但他说他已经能感觉到就是跟雨琦合作肯定会是一个很好的
Going back to Brandon, going back to filming in other countries, have you ever filmed in another country outside of the U.S.?
Filmed Superman Returns in Sydney, Australia. Canada. I've worked in Canada, but that's not really that different.
They don't speak English.
Yes. That's a little bit different. No, it's. I'm excited about the opportunity to go and explore the world. You know, I certainly love to travel and mix culture and, you know, just kind of be in it. It's, you know, it's great to work from home, but it's also a really tremendous experience to be able to travel the world, meet new people, make new friends, and do it in a something that kind of feels like camp. You know, it's a surreal experience and really makes for even a more creative, awesome time when you're able to do it away from home.
所以我主持人问题是，他在除这个电影之外，之前有没有在其他国家拍过？他说，《超人归来》实际上是在悉尼澳大利亚拍的，当然他也有在另一个不是英文国家的国家拍过电影，which is 是加拿大。 然后他说，他觉得他自己个人很喜欢旅行，他觉得这种离开家的感觉，去到另一个地方拍戏，去体验不同的那种文化之间的那种交流，是一个很有激情的感觉。所以他觉得这一次能到马来西亚去工作，是一个很有创造力的经历。所以他觉得
And don't worry, they speak a lot of English in Malaysia.
Chinese, so. I just spent some time in Beijing and years back and had a lovely time and was very well taken care of. So I'm thinking the same would be said in
how long
in Malaysia.
How long?
A week.
那你为什么不会讲国语呢？
关南先生说他其实之前去年也在北京待过一周，然后他觉得他被照顾得很周到，他觉得很开心，他觉得在中国工作实际上应该是一个很美好的经历，所以他这次也很期待在马来西亚工作。然后我主持人说，那你在那待一周为什么不会说中文？然后关南先生不知道怎么回答。
This is a real important question. For this role, can you tell me about your character? Can you tell me please tell me about your character. You know, I know you're just, this is the early stages, but can you elaborate?
My character's name is Mike, it's his. He boards, he's a chef with a bit of a past, which will definitely inform the story as we go along. He has some secrets, as we kind of all do, and those are kind of revealed as he's, tasked with becoming more than a chef.
So he doesn't know this movie. 这个主厨当然不只是一个主厨，他有多余，大大多余主厨的这个东西到大家让大家去发掘。
Kind of a reluctant hero, I guess, of sorts.
Oh, 他并不想成为一个。
Or maybe, tease.
他并不想要成一个超人，但是在这片里，他不幸最后成为超人了，所以。
But a hero in the heart. I guess. Did you set off alarms just by walking by here?
That'd be okay. Don't worry, everybody.
Bring the kryptonite. So when you're working on this role, I mean, every actor works on roles differently, and I don't want to ask a, I understand how actors work, and don't ask a stupid question where, but I really, we all want to know, and the press really wants to know, for this role, especially in the situation that you're in, going to Malaysia, working with a Chinese director, do you feel that you're going to be preparing for this role any differently than other roles, or, and if you could elaborate on how you prepare for a role, not step by step, but, for this kind of...
Yeah. Well, I'm trying to think of what differences, I think the beauty of this project that Vincent has put together is that it's really feeling and will feel like a true Hollywood production. Though we are shifting over where it's being filmed, we have all this, wonderful talent in the Hollywood world that's being shipped over to Malaysia, where we're going to make this film. And just having the brief time that I've had with Vincent, I know that we already will have a good rapport, a good working relationship as we can communicate. And he's very passionate about this project. That influences me in a great way. If he's not passionate about it, then it's hard for me to become passionate about it. He truly is. That makes it easier for me. And so I think, as far as the other preparation, should I stop for a second?
Okay.
And I'll continue?
I don't want you to get lost.
I'll go. I know where to pick up.
Okay. Remember.
Yeah.
所以我的主持人问他, 在准备这个这个角色的时候，和其他的这些角色到底有什么区别？然后，Brandon先生觉得有一点点难回答，但他觉得其实这个也是一个好莱坞级别的阵容，所以其实实际上只不过是把它挪到了马来西亚去拍。所以他之前也一直有跟导演 Vincent 交流，他觉得导演是特别特别有激情把这个电影给完成掉的，所以他觉得由于导演的激情，所以他也很有激情来做这个电影。如果导演没有激情的话，他觉得他自己觉得也迷失了，所以觉得导演的激情对于他是一个很大的鼓舞。
So, the way I like to work is very collaborative. I like to speak with the director a lot, ask opinion. I'm not afraid of having somebody else's idea influence me if it's going to be positive on screen. So, that's part of the way I work. And I think the only thing that would be challenging is maybe just watching the vernacular, the language that I might, this is getting very technical, it's probably not worth saying, but since I want everyone to understand my English, who might not speak English as well, but would like to follow along in English, there's just an extra little bit of attention to be paid to even my enunciation, making it still real, but enunciating and making, you know, paying attention to that quality, I would say. And then, you know, working with, you know, international actors as well, seeing what differences might be there, and just having a cool international cast.
And let me translate. Brandon 超人他说啊，就是说他说的比较专业啊，就因为我们这个电影在现场拍摄的时候，会有英文台词，会有中文台词。中文演员啊，中国演员跟中国演员是说中文台词的。他的意思呢，就是当现场他也在场的时候，当两个中国演员说中文台词的时候，他得去猜他们说什么。他说他要去这个保持他的反应能跟得上他们说的内容。他说这个事情呢对他有点挑战。他是这个意思。其他方面呢，他觉得问题都不大。
How did he do?
He did good.
Is that good?
Yeah, that was true. He also added in, he mentioned a little detail. So it'll be, the actress will be speaking Chinese and you will be speaking English and communicating together, which is great because it takes a lot of really great listening skills to be able to. So. One more question about character.
Yes.
You're going to be playing a chef.
Yes.
Have you ever, are you a good chef or a good cook? Are you going to be doing catering on set? Like, are you going method on this?
The last 2 years of my life, I've gotten very into health and nutrition and cooking a lot of my own meals. I might surprise you with my culinary skills. I fancy myself a home chef. Not restaurant quality necessarily.
我主持人问的问题是，他这次要做一个主厨，那他自己的厨艺到底怎么样？他在现场是不是要给大家做饭呢？他说我不是吓你，他说他在过去的两年之内，他确实也有在家就是自己做饭，就是因为美国这边现在比较在意这种营养学的这种健康嘛，所以他觉得在自己在家做饭的话更有保障。所以他说我现在厨艺的能力不是吓你，应该也不是一般的好，但是没有到饭店的水平。
All right, thank you so much. Thank you, Brandon.
May I add one more thing?
No, sorry, we don't have any time. No, I'm just kidding.
I just overall, I just want to say that I'm excited about this opportunity to work in kind of this, you know, the not even the new, just like the beginning of Chinese cinema, more or less, yes?
Yeah.
In many ways, and having it be one of the first, born in China productions, bringing us over and having us be this co-production is a very cool thing. And, it's exciting to be at the forefront of things like this. It's It's just exciting. It's going to be a cool trip, and I trust that we make a really awesome film that is entertaining for everybody, everywhere.
他觉得整体来说这个应该是一个很激动的电影，他觉得这是一个在中国就是出生的一个电影，但是把整个好莱坞的这个阵容都搬过去了，他自己觉得整体上来讲，他就是觉得很期待这个电影的最后的问世，同时觉得一定是对大家就是会是一个特别有娱乐效果的电影。
Thank you so much. Thank you, Brandon. 谢谢 Brandon. Now that we've had so much handsome energy, and we would like to move on to the beautiful energy of Zhang Yuqi. 我跟你讲英文可以吗？还是 Okay, I'm going to speak to you in English. So you met Brandon for an hour. There's a lot of energy between the two of you. You know, for the screen, of course. Now, how do you find this role and this film different from previous characters that you've worked on? You know. Like CJ7 or White Deer, the one that was just one in Berlin. You know, how do you? Right. Yeah. All
right. And because I have an interest in aviation for many years already, you know, and this character really brings me a lot of challenges, and I have never seen these kind of characters before in Chinese film, right? And I think maybe one day the dreams become true. I'd like to be a pilot in reality.
That's cool. That's cool to have your dream in a, you know, living your dream in a movie. What, can you tell me more about your character as a pilot? More than just you're a pilot, what else about your character?
But I'm not the real pilot, I'm the co-captain. So I didn't hold the, like to do the real, you know, the things to drive the airplane, but I just later I saved the airplane because all the people died on the plane because they have a secret weapon like called black hands. Can I tell people? I'm afraid, you know. Oh yeah, we need to keep secret.
Yeah, same thing for the audience.
Right.
Oh yeah, okay.
Yeah, sorry, too much talk.
所以我的主持人还是希望雨琦小姐多透露一下这个她自己扮演角色的剧情。她说她实际上也不是一个女的驾驶飞行员，她实际上是一个次驾员。然后她在旁边就是帮助一块驾驶飞机。然后她觉得，所以我们先保持这个秘密，最后到今年年底去看。
Yeah, if you want to get any secrets about the film, right now is the time. But we're, you know, this is what we do. We try to find out. Inquiring minds want to know. We also want to know, how does it feel like working with such a handsome, I mean, how does it feel like working with Superman?
Of course, and I'm so excited. Gosh, he's a Superman, you know. I will call my girlfriend, you know, I have his number already. He's an excellent actor, and we definitely work together very well, I hope.
So, 雨琦小姐到底觉得跟这么帅的超人合作会怎么样？她说，当然了，她天哪，她是超人，所以就肯定没什么说的。她说，我们肯定会交换电话号码，然后到时候，告诉我的女朋友，她的电话号码。她会告诉雨琦小姐会告诉她女朋友到底超人电话号码是多少。
What are you most excited about this film and this character that you're going to be playing?
It might be a lot, I think, you know, I love sci-fi films and I watch a lot when I was later, like Star Wars, recently, Interstellar, and this is such a great film. And I think, actually this is my first film acting in English, and for my expectations are to do the best job and one day and continue the acting in the future in more English language films.
所以这个在这个 sci-fi 这个科幻电影里到底郑雨琦觉得是自己是怎么样感觉？他觉得他一直也没有演过一个这个用英文说话的这样一部电影，他希望期待他在未来的演出中能够更多的进入到英文的电影，然后说英文的语言，然后做一个就是中英文双倍的这样一个强力的女演员。
Well, now we'd like to move on. There's more to a film than just directing and acting. And especially with this film, visual effects. We have the director of visual effects. Is that your correct title? The director of...
Typically, it's called visual effects supervisor.
Yes,
but I like director.
This is just the translation, sorry. We have here Bruce Jones, legendary director of visual effects supervisor. Bruce, who's worked on movies like Drag Me to Hell, Star Trek, tons of movies. I mean, go to IMDb and you can get a list. Tell me, Bruce, is there, reading the script and working with Vincent, do you find, without sharing any of the secrets of what's going on in the film, is there any kind of new technology, anything that we're going to see that's new in this film, as opposed to Hollywood films we've seen before?
Yes, but let me first tell you how the movie ends. what we're really doing is we're building on a tradition of Hollywood visual effects, big blockbuster effects that Vincent would like to see brought to the film, and his action scenes. And Creature, I kind of define this more as a action thriller horror almost, because there's an aspect of it that is very frightening. And so what we want to be able to design is characters, creatures, if you will, and I won't give anything away, Vincent, that are familiar yet horrific. So building on that in terms of new technology, we always come up with new and fun ways to do visual effects, and then this film's gonna be no different. We have some real challenges in terms of some of the scale of sets and the amount of creatures that we're bringing into this. And so it'll be a combination of traditional animated techniques that we use for CG characters and some new things that we're playing with in terms of how we create their movements, which is all sort of based off of the designs that we're presenting to Vincent over the next few weeks.
所以我主持人问，就是我们特效导演到底他在这个电影里对于特效的诠释到底有怎么不一样的？首先我们介绍一下，Bruce 先生，他是我们偷天换日的特效导演，同时也是星际迷航的特效导演。他说在这个电影里面和好莱坞所有的特效基本上差别不是很大，但是同时这个对于他的挑战还是一样的，就对于电脑特效还有这个空间的设置以及这种特效的外星人的奇怪的一些就是这种化妆这些东西，他自己还是在尽全力把它做成一个不一样，但是整体上的还是一个好莱坞风格的这种特效的电影，就是这样子。但是Bruce 先生说他不便透露太多的东西对于电影来说，所以现在让我们先保持这个秘密，然后到时候看到底这个星际生物会长什么样子。
Bruce, we have another question for you. Thank you so much. This is going to be in 3D. Do you working in this film in 3D versus just a standard film, is there differences in what you have to undertake in your work?
Yes, technically there's a number of things that we have to bring to the party in terms of, and I won't go into all the details, but how a film is stereoscopic and two images, but a lot of that really comes back to what we'll be doing with our director of photography as well as what Vincent's after. We'll start pre-visualizing the movie. So basically what that allows us to do is to also start thinking about what are some real storytelling points that you do in 3D or in stereo. And It's a new tool that's come out in the last 10 years or so that we've really started to use, which can help, just like when you rack focus on something to bring attention to detail. Now you can do that with stereoscopic, and you can have a creature, if you will, come forward in the scene for a moment of drama, or something recede into the distance. And so those are things that we'll start figuring out early on, so that our dimensionalization team can start thinking about what they have to do technically, and that our director can start thinking about what he wants to do in using that tool for storytelling, and how that all ties into visual effects. Sort of starts at the beginning in storyboard process and goes all the way through to post.
所以主持人问题是，就是这个片子实际上是一个3D电影，到底这个3D在这个电影里呈现的和其他的一些普通的3D电影的区别到底是什么？然后布鲁斯先生说，在这个电影拍的之前，他要跟导演还有这个摄影导演要沟通，他要提前设想好到底他要怎么样子把这个生物这个动物摆到相机前面，然后怎样把它放到后面，怎么样摆这个位置。 最后，他在这个沟通和这个提前设想之后，才能最后决定这个片子的最后的后期制作，以及拍摄的时候到底导演应该怎么样去摆这个位置和这个故事的情节。同时，在这些年里面，他们做的这个特效的风格基本上都差不多，但是他还是希望能在运用更多的这个生物这种化妆和这个。
That's a great translation. but moving on to Scott, who's going to be working with 3D a lot. Hollywood 摄影师 Scott Winnig. Is that correct, Winnig? Is that how it's
pronounced? That is, yeah, Winnig.
Winnig. Scott, can you tell me more about, working with Vincent on this film, and what is the most exciting aspect of you visually shooting this film?
Okay, well, for me, like I'm sure many of us here, it's always starts with the script, you know, and I find a lot of action movies, I'm excited about the action, but I'm not really excited about the rest of the movie. You know, when I read the script, I thought it was a really great balance between story, character, and then that, you know, paralleling with the action. You know, so for me, that's what's exciting. You know, I get, you know, I see characters that then get put into these action scenarios, and that's what moves me as a filmmaker. So, visually, what's interesting is that, I mean, there's many interesting things, but Vincent and I spoke, you know, at first we were talking about palette and color, and how, you know, he's looking for something that's much more vibrant than I think many American films, they tend to, you know, sort of dial back on that, and he's not afraid of that, and that's exciting to me. You know, I mean, there's a lot of challenges with this movie, and, you know, like, we've all seen, you know, films with airplanes. You know, how do you make the inside of an airplane look cool? So we're, you know, collectively designing and coming up with ideas on how to do that, and have some very unique ways of whether it be blocking actors in these scenes, lighting actors in these scenes, so it should be really unique and exciting. I will also note, I have worked in China. I know you've talked with everybody, you've asked everyone, and I did an ad campaign there a year ago. It was one of the most amazing experiences I've ever had. The proficiency in the crews, the production people, and just the overall environment, it was wonderful, and I'm excited to go back. I mean, I know we're going to Malaysia, but, you know, yeah.
所以我主持人问的问题是我们对于我们摄影师就这个电影到底就是他自己对这个电影有什么特殊的感觉？他说他也读过很多相似的这种动作电影，他觉得很多故事缺乏对于这个角色的挖掘。所以他自从读了 Vincent 的这部作品之后，他觉得对于角色的挖掘和这个故事情节的这种发展和这个动作这件事儿，就是这个动作电影这件事儿，他们两个是平行发展的。 所以他发掘了这个角色和这个动作还有故事之间这个融合的关系，同时他说他也跟温森导演一直都有沟通，有一些 闪亮点，他说这个是他差不多头一次是在飞机里面就拍这种飞机内部的这种摄影，所以他也一直在跟 Vincent 导演沟通到底怎么样在飞机内部然后拍出一些特殊的一些这种角度和一种摄影的感觉，他觉得这个会是一个很独特的一个方向，他会去不断的挖掘。同时他说他好像在中国之前也有上海工作过，所以他觉得是一个很好的经历。
One last question for you, Scott. Speaking of, you know, shooting in a plane, that's a very tight space. So how do you make it interesting, you know, shooting in such a tight space, you know, how do you make it different for, you know, different moods and different, what do you require?
I mean, it's movie magic. It's not really that tight, is it? When you can break it apart into multiple pieces and create sets. I mean, I think that's what we do, is you give the illusion that it's really tight so that it puts forth the drama, but technically, we've probably been shooting movies in planes for 50 years, 60 years. I don't, you know, so there's new tricks and there's new things coming out all the time. I think that this will be a unique opportunity to use some of the new technology that's coming out, whether it be, you know, little camera gags and camera trickery and things like that. So, you know, it's exciting.
所以我主持人的问题是，在这么局限性的这个飞机空间里面，到底拍摄会不会有怎么样的困难？到底怎么样能拍出更有独特味道的这个电影？然后我们的导演摄影导演说其实只是给你一个感觉，觉得那是一个很局限的空间在拍，实际上他们有很多不同的方法，在一个足够的空间里面用不同的角度去拍，他们其实觉得有很多的方法可以实现这样的效果。同时他说其实他在飞机的这个空间这样的经历他已经有15年、16年的经历，所以他
50年
You said
50 years,
right?
Oh, I don't
know, I'm wrong. 有很多年的经历，所以他觉得不仅是在运用他比较熟悉的这个方法，同时他也会在用更多的一些相机和一些脚手架的不同的方法来实现一些新的一些技术和感觉在飞机里面拍，所以是一个很好的挑战。
Thank you guys so much. Now we'd like to leave it up to the press to ask any specific questions to anybody.
Can we get Scott's title?
Title?
Yeah.
Well, director of photography,
okay.
Cinematographer, or what do they say in Europe? I don't know.
Cool dude.
cool dude.
I'm going to refer to you.
I don't know. There's a whole bunch of them.
Okay.
I just make things look good, pretty much, or attempt.
Thank you.
My name is Clara. I'm from Tencent, Tengxun. I have a question for the director, Vincent. Why do you choose 3D? Because they're like, you know, in Hollywood, a lot of big directors, they love 3D. Some of them, they don't like using 3D technology. And why do you want to use 3D in this movie?
Actually, I think, yeah, it's also a question for me. Because in my last movie, I shot in 3D. Last part, the movie we shoot in Thailand. Yes, the 3D, you know, the rigs really bring a lot of trouble to us because it takes, you know, a lot of time to do the adjustment, and the size are still so big for us to shoot in a set. So this time we're going to shoot in 2D, but do the conversion later in the post.
所以我们来自腾讯的记者问，为什么导演要拍这个 3D 的这个电影？然后导演说，他之前也在泰国拍这个 3D 电影的时候，觉得这个 3D 确实是个问题。这个 3D 不仅是说在后期，在整个在修改的过程当中会造成很大的问题，同时在现场摄影的时候也会造成很大量的那个消耗，因为它会占很大的空间嘛，所以他说这一次他们会先在 2D 上面拍，然后之后通过后期的特效把它变成 3D， 所以这个是一个新的一个亮点，我觉得。
And actually, I think it's also standard procedure in Hollywood right now. Yeah, more and more, Hollywood productions they should be 2D than do 3D conversion.
所以这个是一个最新的一个流行的好莱坞的制作方法，就是现在先用 2D， 然后再把它转成 3D， 所以它只是跟随着这个整个的潮流来在走，所以应该是一个很好的方式去诠释 3D， 通过 2D。
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Vincent. Any other questions from the press?
I just have a quick question for Brandon. We're used to... Hi, Brandon.
Hi.
We're used to seeing you do a lot of action in your roles, but we're used to also seeing you do a lot in the comic book genre. So what is it about this genre of film that intrigued you?
Well, they're kind of similar. You know, action is certainly present in this film, and raising the stakes is what comic books are a lot, making things larger than life. And that's what this film does. It takes us on an adventure and it lets us kind of escape our humdrum lives maybe, or our worry about, you know, whatever it is we're worrying about. And it's escapist, and this film certainly has that capability. But the great comic book films and adventure films also are able to wrap that story around all that action around a great story and tell, give us a look in on real life and characters' evolution. And there are real journeys that happen in the script. So it's grounded in reality of the characters' lives, even if it may take us to other extremes. So that's what I like about it, and all films like that.
说，关键先生也做过很多这种动作电影，到底这个电影是怎么吸引他的？然后他说，这个电影其实也还是像以往一样是一个动作电影，但他觉得这个电影有更多的在于生活层次上的一个故事情节，所以他觉得在这个电影里面，就是有更多对他自己在于动作电影的影响，所以他觉得这是两个一个综合。
Any other questions? Okay, well, from Vincent's dream and his mind and his inspiration to the paper, to a great script, to actors, assistant directors, visual effects masters, and cameramen, and putting it together and then pre-selling the film, and now it's being made. Making a film is not easy, and this all happened together so smoothly. I hope that, we all hope that the film, everything moves smoothly and beautifully, and you get exactly what your vision and everything that you intended for this film. And we want to thank you all for your time and taking your time to see this film and to get more information. It's coming out March, I'm sorry, it's being filmed in March, March of this year, so it's coming up soon. In Malaysia at Pinewood Studios, the famous Pinewood Studios in Malaysia, where Marco Polo, the Netflix show, was just shot. And we're very excited to see it on screen, which it'll come out very soon, in 2000, the end of this year, is that when it's coming?
It's supposed to release in middle of December.
Middle of December, wow. Okay, well, thank you so much, and thank you, cast and crew, for your time, and go get them. Do a great job.
Thank you.